You guys got number one on the Billboard chart yesterday for best hard rock album, right?
Yes.
Correct.
Congrats.
Thank you very much.
So I know you guys are like big fans of Korn, right? And you have Jonathan Davis on one of the songs of your new album.
Yes.
How's that? Like.
it's sick.
It's wild.
it's one of those things that is just kind of surreal, you know? It's even now that it's over, it's still just like, wow, this is real, you know? So
it's cool to see that song is, there's more to it than even Jonathan just being on it. There's like another part of the song that's even more just like, whoa, like a talking point, I guess, if you will. And to see that it's visibly showing up as a song, like on our streaming, like if you look at Spotify, it's showing up as one of the top listened to songs. And it's just so cool to see that people want to hear, you know, our band with Jonathan and just supporting it. So it's pretty awesome.
You guys were also nominated for this year's APMAs for most dedicated fan base.
Yes.
But I also know that you don't like social media personally.
Well, as I just had a conversation with somebody else, it's not even necessarily social media. It's just a lot of the people that use social media. I don't know. Social media is just such a major part of the world today, and especially within the music industry as far as marketing. So it's really hard to be like, I hate it or anything like that, because you need it. So it's just trying to embrace it and stay away from the shit that you don't want to be around and you don't want to see. And it's gotten to a point where I feel like I can't even be excited about anything anymore. Like I can't be excited about announcing a video or a tour or something, because I just know that it's immediately going to result in just negativity. I mean, there's just as much positivity, but of course, I don't know why in the world the negative things seem to like reign over the positive. I don't know why that is. Do you have something to say about it?
Trolls, man.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
Can we say that social media is a necessary evil?
Perhaps that's what the song is about. Some would say that the song may be about that necessary evil.
My God.
Uh-huh. What was it like growing up in Scranton?
I can't actually see myself leaving. There's something about the area that there's enough population in like city area, but right outside of everywhere, it's like lakes, streams, mountains, hiking, all that kind of stuff. And probably another thing people don't know about me, I actually really enjoy all that stuff.
Do you guys write and record in Scranton?
We work far better with each other remotely, but when we do work together, we work there, and it's just super easy. Very just, you want to get together today? Sure, let's do it. And it's just relaxing to be around. Even when it gets stressful, it's just cool because we can just take a break and go outside. It's easy.
Graveyard Shift is your newest album. Are there any like messages you're trying to get across, or like what's like the oomph of the album?
I would say three-fourths of the album plus the title are centered around just, you know, working really hard and that just relentless, resilient mentality of just pushing and never. You know, I know everyone always talks about how cliche and overplayed that message is, but for us, that's just something that really stands true. I mean, like, we're what I believe to be an underdog story, and we're out here at Rockin' the Range for our third year. We're going to be we keep having these amazing things happen, and it's not just by coincidence or by luck. It's because we worked our asses off. There's a lot of songs on the album that are central to that theme, including, of course, the album title. So. Yeah.
Well, thanks for chatting with me, guys. Congrats on your success.